I heard the execution of my brother.
برادرم به همراه 85 نفر دیگر تیرباران شد.
My brother was executed along with 85 other people.
و ما شنیدیم صدای رگبار رو.
And we heard this event.
و صدای تفجیرها رو شمردیم.
We heard the firing squad as well as the coup de grace bullet.
اون شب اولین بار نبود.
That evening was not the first time.
و باز ادامه پیدا کرد.
And it continued.
اون زمان من شکنجه دیدم، شکنجه سوزه شلاق رو شنیدم.
I heard and I saw torture, the whippings.
چیزی در من شکست.
Something broke in me at that in that time.
دنیا دیگه اون دنیایی نبود که من.
The world was no longer the one that I recognized.
و منم دیگه اون آدم نبودم که قبلش بودم.
And I certainly was not the person who'd been before.
و من فکر می‌کنم که بعد شروع کردم بعد از آزادی به نوشتن کار کردن نمیدونم.
After liberation I began to put my thoughts together, started writing.
همه اینها و همچنین همکاری با بنیاد برومند برای جمع‌آوری.
All of this led to the cooperation with Burumand Foundation in order to start making a set of documentation and archive.
همه اینها برای این هستش که بگم که.
All this is in order to.
اون چی که اتفاق افتاد.
That which happened.
نباید اتفاق می‌افتاد.
Should not have happened.
این هست.
This is it.
The simple truth.
This is the simple truth.
First of all, I should appreciate Ladan and Roya Burumand and all their colleagues, Reza, Guli, and also Mehri. I know that he's not here, and the others also. Maybe I don't know their names. And just I appreciate their work. And
Lydia, Krista.
And also I should say that I'm here. Just I'm not. I don't believe that I deserve this kind of, for, because I believe that those persons, my fellow prisoners, my friends, my beloved ones, who were in that corridor and they couldn't leave that corridor, they deserve this. And I should say that maybe in those days, they were in those corridors. But you see, even this year, in 2011, one of my friends, who was more than 20 years in prison, he was executed because just he had 1 minute speech in Khavaran. It's very easy for me to speak here about my friends, about massacre, about the places that the my beloved ones are buried, but without any danger for me, you see. But he was in Iran, and he was in Khavaran, and he had a speech for 1 minute. He was executed, and his name is not mentioned in the report of Ahmad Shaheed. And you see, this is the problem. If I'm here, if I'm trying to talk about violation of human rights in Iran, I'm talking about the real atmosphere of Iran, the real violation of human rights in Iran, not you see our here. You see Abbas, one of my friends over there, four of his brother and sister were executed. Two of her sister were killed during the massacre, and her mother in that time was in prison, and she couldn't say even goodbye to her beloved daughters. Two of brothers were killed. I mean, we are talking about the disappearances in Iran, and his nephew was also killed under torture. His brother is one of those disappearances in Iran. This is the case that he was a friend of mine. After 10 years being in prison, he was released, and then he was arrested. He was rearrested. He was killed, and nobody accepted the responsibility for that, because during the Rafsanjani's presidency after 1988, it was the policy of the Iranian regime to rearrest the political prisoners, to kill them, and not to accept the responsibility for that. I'm trying just to mention these kind of things here and there. You see, here we are in England. The Amnesty International was established here in this country, but I try just to tell them, please mention the name of one of my friends. He was paralyzed. He was 14 years in prison in Iran. He was paralyzed. He cannot speak normally. He's almost blind. He cannot walk. He cannot even move his hands. But they didn't even mention his name in their reports. Because even human rights, we have selectivity, even in human rights. As you see, even I tried Mr. Capitol, when he was going to Iran, I asked him to mention his name. I asked him just to meet him. I gave him the information, but he didn't. When he came back, I said, why? Even you didn't mention my name in your report. He told me that, okay, I ask you deeply apologize. And nothing happened. And even after that, he didn't mention the name of the real political prisoner in Iran who are under pressure, under torture in their reports. This is the problem. Now we see. And I ask you, those who are here representing human rights and trying to represent human rights in Iran, just see what's going on in Iran. You see, today I see that the problems to file a suit against the perpetrators of violation of human rights in Iran. And you see, we have these kind of things against Rumsfeld nowadays, but not about Iranian, Khamenei, Khatami, or also Rafsanjani and the others. We don't have it. You see, those things which happens in Guantanamo Bay or in Abu Ghraib, we didn't call them torture in Iran. I'm coming from that country that we as political prisoner. And also the torturer. We didn't those kind of things, torture. Really, we didn't tell that things, torture. We say Melikhori, and it's not torture. And we were very happy that they didn't torture us. Thank you very much for giving me this.
In the defense of the human rights community, I have to say that it's not easy to document. It's very hard to document because there are so many people. Jennifer was with us doing a lot of interviews. She knows how frustrated the victims are and how angry they are. And that is why we have to say and we have to document, because there is no other way of getting anger away from them. But there are so many of them who have worked a lot. Mr. Aslani is one. He goes every summer from one town to another and one country to another to tell the story and to tell the story. And so, you know, even for human rights organizations, if you have thousands and thousands of victims, it's very hard to pick. I mean, how did we pick Iraj and Monire? You know, it was such a hard thing.
Excellent introduction, because Monire has something with regard to this.
دوستان من request جمع بزرگی از این جمعیت که اینجا هستیم از دوستان همبندی ما بودن، کسایی بودن که ما سال 60 با هم بودیم.
Some of the people who are here were amongst my friends who were in the same cells with me in the 1960s.
بخششون ادراشون دور بود رفتن. من میخوام خواهش بکنم واقعا.
I really want to request, please.
دوستان که اینجا هستن بیان حداقل یک عکس یادگاری برای هم.
Those who were in our cells, could they please come forward so we can at least have a photograph together, at least.
خواهش می‌کنم.
Please come.
آقا اینم بیان
همه فکران ما
مناسب عبا
من به عنوان یه فعال حقوق بشر که در انگلیس فعالیت‌های حقوق بشری می‌کنم، واقعا خوشحالم که امشب تو این برنامه بودم و خیلی موضوعایی که با اینکه من همیشه در جریان هستم و چک می‌کنم، باز خیلی موضوعایی بر من روشن شد که هرگز من نمی‌دونستم. اگه اینجا نیامده بودم این اتفاقات رو نمی‌تونستم به این روشنی و خوبی ببینم. و متشکرم از بنیاد برومند که این شانس رو به ما داد با همکاری دانشگاه آکسفورد که ما روشن بشیم بیشتر در جریاناتی که در ایران اتفاق می‌افته.
من فکر کنم برنامه بسیار جالبی بود. به هر حال مسئله اعدام‌های سال 67 بزرگترین جنایتی است که در جمهوری اسلامی ایران اتفاق افتاده و هنوز خانواده‌های این قربانیان بعد از 23 سال به حداقل خواسته‌هاشون در مورد نحوه اعدام، چگونگی اعدام و چرایی اعدام و مهمتر از همه این که با اجساد این افراد چه شده نرسیدن. امروز در این جلسه مسئله از دید زوایای مختلف مورد بررسی قرار گرفت، هم به لحاظ حقوقی مسئله مورد بررسی قرار گرفت و هم به نمونه‌هایی که در کشورهای دیگه در مشابه این رخ داده مسئله مطرح شد و به خصوص این که چه راه‌هایی برای دنبال کردن این مسئله به لحاظ حقوقی و سیاسی وجود داره. فکر می‌کنم در مجموع جلسه بسیار موفقی بود و من به این دلیل از بنیاد عبدالرحمن برومند بسیار سپاسگزاری می‌کنم که این جلسه رو سازمان دادن و تونستم برنامه رو برگزار کنم.
سمپوزیوم بسیار خوبی بود، به خصوص که قربانیان این جنایات آمدن اینجا گزارش دادن و تقریبا با احساسات کامل نشون دادن که چه فجایعی سرشون آمده. و در امروز ما صحبت داشتیم از تمام کشورهایی که دچار این مصیبت بودن، علاوه بر ایران گزارش بسیار جامعی از وضع حقوق بشر در ایران داشتیم و امیدواریم که اینها رو بتونیم در یک زمانی به یه نتیجه قطعی برسونیم، به خصوص که ما در جون آینده کمیسیون حقیقتیاب رو داریم در لندن تشکیل میدیم که حدود 100 نفر از این شهود اونجا خواهند آمد و گزارش این جریانات رو خواهیم داشت. امیدواریم که کسانی که در ایران این کارها رو انجام میدن فکر عاقبت کار خودشون رو هم بکنن.
ببینید در واقع برگزاری این نوع سمپوزیوم ها کمک میکنه به مطرح شدن موضوع نقض حقوق بشر در ایران و به ویژه قتل عام و کشتار زندانیان سیاسی در سال 67. اگر توجه داشته باشید در طول 23 سال گذشته عملا صحبتی در این مورد نبوده. ما میبینیم بعد از 23 سال آقای موسوی اردبیلی که رئیس دیوان عالی کشور در اون دوره بودن میان و میگن من مخالف این کشتار بودم، برخلاف تمامی اسنادی که موجوده، یا آقای مهندس موسوی میگن که اون موقع نخست وزیر بودن. در واقع اینها همشون فرصت اینو داشتن که در 23 سال گذشته این موضوعات رو مطرح کنن، ولی امروز وقتی که میان و این موضوع رو مطرح میکنن و محکوم میکنن، یا خودشون رو فاصله بین خودشون و این کشتارها در واقع و این نقض حقوق بشر ایجاد میکنن، نشون دهنده اینه که این نوع روشنگری ها، این نوع سمپوزیوم ها، کنفرانس ها و دیگر فعالیت هایی که در زمینه روشنگری در ارتباط با کشتار سال 67 یا دیگر موارد نقض حقوق بشر در ایران برگزار شده مؤثر بوده. به همین دلیل من خودم فکر میکنم که هرچه این سمپوزیوم ها بیشتر باشه، هرچه این کنفرانس ها بیشتر باشه و هرچه این روشنگری ها بیشتر باشه، کمک میکنه به بهبود وضع حقوق بشر در ایران و بهبود شرایط در واقع ایران برای مدافعان حقوق بشر و برای کسانی که در اونجا فعالیت میکنن.
اگه بپذیریم که یکی از راه‌های مقابله با خوره فراموشی و تاخ زدن اون با یاد و حافظه میتونه تکرار باشه، برگزاری سمپوزیوم‌هایی از این دست که امروز در آکسفورد برگزار شد در نشوندن یاد و حافظه به جای فراموشی میتونه مؤثر باشه و برای فردایی که چندان دوردست نیست و جانیان میبایست آمران و عاملان پاسخگوی اون پلیدی ها باشند میتونه بسیار مهم.
هدف از برگزاری این برنامه این بود که قربانیان و بازماندگان کشتار 67 رو با حقوقدانان و کارشناسان حقوق بین الملل در تماس بگذاریم که در مورد راهکارهای و چاره دادخواهی با هم مشورت کنند و ببینند که چه راههایی هست بعد از اینکه جنایت کشتار زندانها توسط قاضی رابرتسون تعریف شده به عنوان کشتار جنایت علیه بشریت، برای دادخواهی چه میشه کرد.